Hi, my name is Aseem. I am working as a consultant for the National Geophysical Research Institute on a project they are doing in collaboration with the DRDO. I am a physicist and my specialization is in the field of seismology. Basically, I study how different structures, both natural and man-made, suffer under the stress of an earthquake. I'm going to talk about an experimental project that is being run by capitalist lobbies using public institutions like the judiciary, municipality, bureaucracy, and of course the paramilitary. Now, we all know that most scientific research is dominated by the requirements of the military-industrial complex. But this project, I would like to point out, is a little special. In this project, we're looking at how urban infrastructure can be used as a means to breed fear into the population, so that the janta lives in a perpetual state of panic. The idea of using fear by the state to control, even subjugate the population, is not new. It's happening constantly around us. Whether you look at the tribal situation in central India, or even if you look at the Eyes and Ears campaign by the Delhi police, it is basically trying to make glorified terror objects out of every oddity in the public domain. Both public and personal spaces are getting more and more surveillance these days, and access is being increasingly denied on the pretext of security. In this context, some derelict and abandoned spaces present a tremendous potential because they remain outside the circuitry of modern surveillance. After a lot of research and testing, we even did a small test at Pokhran. We have come up with a way to maximize the impact of seismic forces using minimal sustainable interventions. Here we have installed indigenously developed nanomomentum colliders below each tower. These nanomomentum colliders transform vertical seismic loads into a horizontal force and horizontal seismic loads into a vertical force, thus substantially increasing the chance of structural failure. Basically, a certain part of the structure is forced to move in a perpendicular direction to the rest of the environment. In this particular case, we have installed three separate structures. They work more or less like bunker-busting missiles in the sense that once they start moving down, they have the capacity to cut through three or four concrete slabs before losing inertia. Not only does this allow for damage through many floors of a structure, it also makes the building as a whole very unstable. We have so much control that we can predict with a 90% certainty in which direction the building will collapse. This experiment has been designed such that the building will fall straight in front onto the main road. It has also been theoretically calculated that the impact of the collapse will ensure the structural failure of at least two columns of the metro line nearby. And if a metro train were to glide onto the traffic jam below, it could be catastrophic. We just have to wait for a good earthquake to see this spectacle of state-endorsed terror. We have also used special emulsions to give some sort of memory to this intervention. As you can see, the structures are all loosely fitted and they are meant to eventually disintegrate. So the emulsions provide future researchers with clues as to the original composition of the intervention so that they can improve on the design for future experiments. As the half-life of the emulsion is over 1,000 years, therefore it also provides future archaeologists with evidence of not only the state of seismological research, but also clues to the urban environment and its control by pseudo-state power centers. I would also like to point out that the project provides a safe exit in terms of litigation, as there are many, many layers of proxy bodies that have been made to participate in this program. So you can't really hold any one particular person or organization responsible. For example, the Delhi police, the MCD, as well as the Supreme Court has had an active hand in creating the situation that allowed this experiment to be executed. Without their help, this project would have been impossible. Even if there is a case, the Supreme Court can't implicate itself, can it? It can only annul the previous judgment. There is no way of establishing any connection with the capitalists, except perhaps that the builders and politicians have gained the most from the closure of these so-called unauthorized buildings.